Absolutely. AgriBuzz, the weekly agricultural feature on Sunnyside Up. Now, peppers are a common ingredient in many dishes around the world and are used because they add a unique flavor to any kind of meal. There are over 150 varieties of hot pepper, and each one has a unique taste. Locally, there are two peppers of economic value. That's the Scotch Bonnet and West Indian Red Peppers. We've been speaking about them for a bit. They're grown under the ministry's incentive program managed by the Rural Agricultural Development Authority, RADA. And here to share with us more about his experience as a farmer growing hot peppers under the program is Carlos Williams. We got him on the phone. Welcome to AgriBuzz, Mr. Williams. How you do?
Good morning, Ms. Paula. Good morning to your listeners and all farmers over there.
Okay, and we wish you the best of the morning, top of the morning to you too. Mr. Williams, we hear that there is over 150 different kinds of peppers. What kinds of peppers are you growing?
I'm presently growing Scotch Bonnet peppers.
The Scotch Bonnet?
Yes.
Okay, this is the one that's red?
No, that's the one that's yellow.
This is, the Scotch Bonnet is yellow?
Yes.
All right, got you. And where is it that you're farming?
Oh, I'm in Canaan, in Dumfries, St. James.
Canaan, Dumfries, St. James. Give me directions. How do we get to Canaan? Where that?
Wow. It's in St. James, where Adelphi, coming from Adelphi.
Okay. All right. I have an idea now. So what other kinds of crops have you been cultivating, Mr. Williams?
Presently, I have over 700 bank of yellow yam. Presently putting in sweet potato, and I also do corn and okra and small scale.
Okay, so why did you choose the peppers?
Well, Scotch Bonnet peppers is a very profitable market. It's very profitable. It's a market that with amount of profit on it. I chose it. It's very hard, but I chose to plant it.
You say it's very hard. Why do you say it's hard?
It's hard because you have lots of disease and it takes. It's like a baby. You have to take care of it like a baby.
Mm-hmm.
Where you have to be in it on a daily basis to ensure that everything goes according to plan.
Mm-hmm. Okay, so you have the threat from disease. What are the challenges you have as you grow Scotch Bonnet?
The challenge is you have mite. That's one of the biggest challenges. Mite is one of our biggest challenges. So you have to continue spray like every 3 weeks to avoid mite from it.
Okay. Do you have challenges with Prairie Larceny?
No, not in my era. Not in Canaan. We don't have challenges with Prairie Larceny at all. Okay. Not in Canaan.
And despite the challenges, you have been at it. You've been doing the work, putting in the work. How much have you reaped since you started?
Since I started, this is my third pepper. This is my third Scotch Bonnet crop.
Mm-hmm.
I reap actually 600 pounds every week. So 600 to 1,000 pounds of Scotch Bonnet every week.
600 pounds a week? Wow.
Yep.
How much pepper is in a pound?
Normally it's about 20 to 25 will give you a pound.
20 to 25 peppers. That's a lot of peppers.
Yes, that's a lot.
Oh.
That's a lot of peppers.
Well, we continue to wish you all the best, sir, as you take this on, the Scotch Bonnet farmer that you are. Any advice you have for people who are thinking of taking on Scotch Bonnet?
Yes, I would tell them that it's a very profitable crop.
Mm-hmm.
You can plant it, but you have to take full care of it. You cannot plant it and leave it. You have to be in it, stay in it on a daily basis to ensure it comes to perfection.
Got it.
Okay. And I don't want to pick up our RADA officers and our extension officers.
Mm-hmm.
They are very good to us. They help us a lot. That Mr. Johnson and Mr. Holt. They really look out for the farmers.
Mr. Ricardo Holt, huh?
Yes.
That's the man. Thank you for sharing with us this morning, Mr. Williams.
Thank you, ma'am. Have a blessed day now.
You too. That's Carlos Williams, hot pepper farmer, sharing his experience. He is is farming under the ministry's production incentive program. And did you know that high demand for Jamaican pepper products places an equally high demand on Jamaican hot peppers? Countries like the United States, Costa Rica, China, and Vietnam are Jamaica's main import partners for hot pepper commodities. So let's continue to support our farmers by eating what they grow as they grow what we eat. For information on what's happening in the agricultural and agro-industry sector, please visit the ministry's website at mycalf.gov.jm. Follow them on Instagram and Twitter. Check them out on Facebook. And listen again next week for another Agro Buzz.